was good. Keith Jennings back in the studio just to give you a final conclusion over the LeBron 10. And I guess I'll start off by saying, for one, I like the LeBron 10 design. I think it's one of LeBron's dopest silhouettes to date. Two, it's a good performer. I know, do you think it performed well for you?
To be honest, I actually did like the way it performed, but if I had a complaint on the LeBron 10, it would probably be just the flexibility. I feel like it could have been a lot better.
Yeah, I don't even think it has to do so much with the upper, because the upper with the high quality fuse, dynamic flywire, all that great stuff, that was really great. But it had to do more with the midsole, the bottom, towards the bottom of the shoe. It just didn't feel like it had that one-to-one movement as you hooping in the Kobe 8 or me with the D-Rose. If you look at the D-Rose, you'll see multiple flex screws throughout the bottom, the traction. And on the LeBron 10, you maybe have one flex screw, two. So the flexibility, that was definitely a downfall to the LeBron 10.
Also, I want to just touch on the weight. As we all know, the LeBron is a heavier shoe. You know, coming from the Kobe 8, as Trey mentioned, I felt like it did hinder my moves a little bit. But you know, it wasn't too bad. What do you think, bro?
I mean, just moves, like, not even necessarily speed or, you know, taking away from your vertical. It's just more agility type moves. I feel like it took away from that. But you really can't argue with the cushioning. You have a 360 Air Max unit setup combined with the Zoom Air. So, you know, impact protection, great.
And also, don't forget about the secure lockdown. As we both know, the LeBron had the dynamic flywire, which also helped with that. And then, you know, if you're wondering, the shoe does run through the size, so you know it's also going to give you that snug fit that you're looking for.
So overall, man, the LeBron 10, definitely a dope shoe on and off the court. I can't necessarily say it's my go-to shoe at the moment. The D-Rose 3, I do prefer that shoe. But if I was at the gym, forgot my D-Roses and had my LeBron 10s, then I'm good to go.
I also agree with that statement. The LeBron 10 is a dope shoe. As we all know, the Kobe 8 is my go-to shoe at the moment. But like you said, if you're more of just a power player or just somebody who's just more aggressive, then definitely go with the LeBron 10.
Yeah, man, for your performance needs, definitely check out kicksonport.com. Link will be in the description box. Other than that, it's Kick Genius, and we out.
We out, man.